And Trent came out to me and he started to cry and he said, Mum, I've done something terrible. And he said, I've had a sexual encounter with Tia or something to those words.
Okay, I was going to say, were they
No, probably not the words, but yeah, I don't really remember exactly what it was then, but yeah it indicated that he'd had a sexual encounter with Tia. Yeah.
The message was clear.
It was, yeah. And I said, oh my God, mate.
So you were shocked?
I was absolutely stunned, shocked. I said, oh mate, no, how could you let something like that happen? And he sort of briefly expressed to me that she had come on to him and that she had threatened our Labrador's life if he didn't do it. So that really concerned me.
Yeah.
I said, we will deal with it. Don't let it worry you, just go to dance, do what you've got to do. We will talk about all this and just try and get it out of your head sort of thing. I did say to Rick that Trent just came and told me that he'd had a sexual encounter with Tia, and Trent had indicated to me that it was the Sunday previous.
And how was his reaction?
I wouldn't say he was cross, but he was disturbed about it. And he was very concerned because he knows the implications for a boy of his age with a girl of her age.
Of course.
He was adamant about him doing jail time, that he'll go to jail for something like this.
Yeah.
So Rick was, extremely concerned about that.
Yeah.
And he couldn't allow Trent to go to jail. He just can't let it happen. We were concerned she could be pregnant or something.
And did you have that conversation with Rick at that time?
I think it did.
Okay.
It was mentioned.
Yeah.
That no, pains in the stomach. No, we were worried that she could be pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
We just all felt that that we had to keep it to ourselves, and we would get Trent some help, like a psychologist. And we would make sure that Tia was okay, and make sure she wasn't pregnant. Hopefully, and if she was, we would deal with it. And we would look after her and make sure everything was all right.
The last time that you saw Tia Palmer alive, when was that?
In her bedroom, sitting on her bed.
Okay.
I said goodnight to her there.
Yep.
And expressed to her that she needed to stay there and put herself to sleep when she was ready, sort of thing.
Mm-hmm. And where was Rick?
I think he was outside the kitchen door, waiting for me to come back outside.
Was there anyone else in the house?
Nobody else in the house, no.
And then you left?
Mm-hmm. I got inside and I said to Rick, was Tia okay? And I think he said something about, the exact words, it's all taken care of or something. So what do you mean by that? So don't worry, don't ask any questions, I've taken care of it. And I went to go to her room and he said, don't go in there. I said, why not? And he said, I told you it's sorted, it's taken care of. I said, what do you mean? He said, don't ask any questions. I guess I had a gut feeling that something wasn't right, but I couldn't really do much about it. If that's what he's done, I didn't want to see it or know anything about it. So.
So you didn't ask him direct?
No. No.
And did he tell you direct?
No. He backed the car over to the shed, the big shed where all the cars are. That's all I saw.
What do you think he was doing at that point?
Putting her body in the boot of the car. I had a feeling that she could have been in his shed, but I didn't want to see her anyway.